they're not very friendly. So
yeah.
You try to talk to someone, and they're like, yeah. Vietnam is very different. Everyone's yeah. very friendly, yeah, open.
Yeah.
Some people here, don't know about English.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. English. Right. Right, a little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, the Korean, I've heard, they study English a lot,
yes.
but they don't speak it very much.
Mm-hmm.
So they're very nervous when you speak to them.
Do you speak another language?
Spanish.
Spanish. Can you share about some experience following another language?
Some yeah. what?
Experience or yeah. some tip? Or,
some tip?
Yeah. Yeah. Like, yeah, how do you learn Spanish? And like the, so that you can share to everybody here so that they can know what the best way for them to learn English faster.
Learn the best way to learn English faster.
Yeah. Oh, well, man. Because actually we don't have very much foreigner, so many foreigner here mm-hmm. to speak with, and so we need to learn by ourselves like this here. And do you have any your strategies or something like that too?
Well, I feel like if I was in your situation,
yes.
and I would try to find somebody online to speak with,
mm-hmm.
Somebody online to do Skype or
yes.
chatting on mm-hmm. Facebook or something, just try to talk as much as I can with other people online
yeah.
is a good way.
Yeah, yeah.
If in person there's not many people to talk
yeah.
to.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I learned Spanish in a classroom. And so it took a very long time to learn in a classroom, but when I would speak to Spanish people,
mm-hmm.
like on my soccer team, I had a lot of Spanish people, and when I spoke to them, I learned the most. So I think speaking is the best way, and maybe just online, then.
Yeah.
I'm not sure where.
yeah.
Online chat rooms.
That's nice.
When you go to Java, you, when did you,
what did I prepare? Oh, okay. I sold everything that I owned in America. I had a motorcycle and I sold that, and my entire furniture and all my clothes, sold everything. And I have just a backpack. And so my backpack just has pretty much some clothes. I have a hammock. Do you know what a hammock?
Hammock.
Hammock is a
yes.
like a tent that you can hang between trees and sleep in. So I have a hammock.
Yes.
And my motorcycle gear, my helmet and motorcycle jacket.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
How much did you buy?
And a laptop. We brought a laptop.
How much did you buy the motorcycle?
The motorcycle was $400.
$400. 8 million. Yeah. 8 million
Binando.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's
okay.
It's
just a new one, so an old one.
It's an old one. They don't make new.
Yeah, actually. In the past, my father has one, but now, yeah, he sold it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who do I live with? Who do I travel with? It's one of my friends from San Francisco. We both do motorcycling and rock climbing. Sports together, and so we both decided to quit our jobs to travel. So we travel together now.
Mm-hmm.
You can see my country is full. What do you want to do when you come back from hometown to help every people in my country?
Yeah, hard question.
How can I come to help people in your hometown? Is that what you're asking?
My country is full.
Yes.
In the next time, in the future, you can. You come back to the hometown, yes?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want to do to help?
Well, I guess I can come teach. Yes. I can come teach English and programming if you guys want.
Yeah.
So maybe you can help some people here can learn English.
Like now, you are helping people here learn English, talking with them one way. Yes.
Do you have many experience in
I mean, so I worked through college.
Yeah.
Can you tell me and many people like about the law?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can use. So, for my job, I like to work in very small companies because when you work at a small company, you have so much more responsibility, and you control so much more of the decisions that the company makes. So my company that I was at only had six people.
Six people.
And only three engineers. Mm-hmm. So when you're on such a small team, it's very fun because you can sit down with your two other friends and talk about, like, let's build this, let's make this.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the decision I want to make.
Yeah.
And so it's very fun. I worked at a very big companies, American Express before, and I'm not a very big fan of the large corporation because of the lack of decisions that you can make. So,
yeah.
I like a small company. So for my job, I was doing statistics a lot. You know statistics?
What
is a type of math that has to do with large data, very big numbers, and understanding trends. And so I would take restaurants, you know restaurants?
Yes.
I would take restaurant sales data, so what they sell, and I would program to make it so that you could sell more, basically.
Yeah.
Using statistics, so the type of math.
Like, you do like marketing?
Marketing?
Restaurant?
Our company did, yes.
Yeah.
So we would do marketing.
So maybe you have a lot of experience for working in team, right?
What's that?
Teamwork.
Yes.
Yeah. Can you share?
Teamwork experience?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, it's like I said, the small company is fun because your team are like the CEO of the company, the leader of the company is your friend.
Yes, friend.
So, you know, like I would go play basketball with my CEO every day and
that
type of thing. Very close family.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, just very informal in
this
work environment. Very, you know, casual, just talking and, you know, like just very open-minded to say whatever you want to say.
Yeah, maybe more creative. When like that,
creative. There was many times we would stay at work till 1 a.m., 2 a.m. just because we were so excited about some idea. We'd be like, oh my god, like let's, you know, make this, and we just, you know, back and forth.
Yeah.
It's very fun.
Again.